Another important component that you can utilize in your course is his live sessions with your students, and this would come in handy, particularly in online courses. So to add an online session, and by the way, this is an add-on to e-learning or to Moodle here, it's called Big Blue Button. So what you can do is you can add an activity called Big Blue Button, and then click on Add. You give it a name for this virtual classroom. It's also important to put the time that you are going to meet with the students so that they all show up at the same time zone that you expect them to show up. You can put a welcome message here. And now all users will be viewers, and you as the teacher, you'll be the moderator. However, you can change this to make the students as moderators automatically as well. However, be cautious of that, because they'll be able to start the chat room without you being there. You can also specify the times when the chat will open and it will be closed automatically, but keep track of the dates and so on when you teach the course again. Now, the other thing that you can do is you can choose to record this session and you can give it a name. Now, by the way, to record it, it will not record it automatically. You have to push the record button when you're ready to while you're in the live session. And then you can leave these other options alone there and just click on save and return to the course. Now, when it's time for you to meet with the students live and when it's time for the students to be a part of this live web conference, they'll be simply clicking on it. So you'll all be simply clicking on it. And then it's going to open up the software for the live session. So this is integrated. It's not part of Moodle, but it's an add-on that is fairly easy to configure. And by the way, it's free. Then you choose to enable the microphone, and the student will choose the microphone or whether they want to just listen. And at this point, for the sake of me recording with my microphone and using to share with this, it will not particularly work very well. I'm not going to enable it at this point. Now, the students that have joined the session, they will show up in this list here on the left-hand side, and you'd be able to click on their name here and make them presenters if need be. Their web cameras will show up on this bottom right corner here, and by the way, you can resize these blocks if you needed to, or make it full screen and maximize it. Now, in this middle section here, it gives you directions as to how to use this software, and I'd suggest that you kind of follow these links to these videos. But basically, this is the area where you can post a document or post something. Like, this is your whiteboard area, basically, for the students. You can click on next slide here if you needed to and utilize this to write on this screen, and this will be broadcast to all students, including your video and your audio. Now notice you can use these shapes and so on here, the pencil to write on this screen, and if you have a tablet PC, it might even be easier for you. Other things, of course, you can change the colors and all kinds of other options here as well. Now, when you go to present in your course, you need to enable the microphone from here on the left under Share Your Microphone, and it will come up with this wizard. And of course, you choose to use the microphone. And then if you wanted to share the camera, you just click on this next icon here, choose Share Webcam, and you'd need to allow it. And then it's going to give you a preview of your camera, and then you'll just click on Start Sharing when you're ready to do that. So you need to choose Allow here. If you don't choose Allow, it's not going to allow the camera to be broadcast to the students. The other thing here is this is the button for starting the recording for this session. By the way, the recordings will not be immediately available for you or for the students. Usually it's about next day that it's processed, and it happens automatically behind the scenes for that processing of the video. The other thing that you can do is you can share your complete desktop, and this would require that you have Java installed on your computer. Most computers do and don't nowadays because it's so vulnerable that most browsers are disabling it, but it requires Java to work on your computer, and you can test it from down here in the bottom. So on the right-hand side, you'll always have students potentially that for one reason or another, their microphone or camera is not working. This is where they can post questions and you can post responses back to the students using this chat area here on the right hand side. So basically this tool, it's incorporating chat, video, audio, and also presentation capabilities all into one. For those of you that are teaching online, there is also another account that we have with any meeting, and just check with the technology services for getting access to using that as well as an option. So that's how it would work. Now to get out of this area, we just simply click on log out. By the way, to type in the chat area here, you just type right here and hit enter and it'll post it for the students. Of course, you can change the font if you needed to under options to make that larger so you can see what's happening in the chat room. So if I were to type now, notice everything is larger. To exit the system, to close from the conference session, you click on exit or log out here in the top right, and that will take you back to the course page. The nice thing about this system is that everything is integrated. The students to have another account, everything is in one place. Now, the next day, when it comes time for you to post a recording, what you have to do is, because the recording will not show up automatically, you have to click on add a resource or activity, and you have to scroll down here and choose to post big blue button recording. You click on add, and then you'll give it a name. Of course, a more meaningful name. Then you'd click on save and display, and then you'll pick the recording from here. So it will actually be listed in here the next day after it's been produced and packaged. So that's how the live conferencing works. It can be used for on-site classes or online classes as well.